Hello guys, KP Shamino here with my video for Path of Exile, and my build is finally done. So what did I do? I did around 100 to 140 maps on standard, tier 14 to 16. I only died once, and I need to say it works really, really well with the updates on the masteries and all that stuff. It's, I think, one of the best builds that I ever made. So it's my Juggernaut, Cyclone, General's Cry, Earth Shatter. So what are you doing? You're turning around, you always push General's Cry, it's only 1.8 seconds cooldown, and they are going to do Earth Shatter with the next General's Cry. You let explode the spikes, and it's very tanky. I got at the moment 26% less damage taken from Fortify, 5% less taken from the Ascendancy in Juggernaut, physical damage reduction capped, so it's very strong. It's unbelievable how good it plays, and I will show you guys it in this video. So what's the plan? As always, I'm going to start with a gameplay, a Chimera tier 16 map. You guys will see it. Then I'm coming back for you guys with the gear, the flasks. I'm going to show a little bit the tree in game 2, because the masteries, I don't think that they are yet updated in Path of Building. Then it's Path of Building, the Ascendancies, and that's it, guys. So I see you guys after the gameplay.
I cannot do this yet.
Crucible.
Okay, guys, I'm going to show you guys in this part the gear. So let's get started right away. So you guys can see I'm playing with the Maul. So what do you need to have on the Maul? That's very simple. That's like, physical damage. The higher the physical damage, the better. This is a 6-link too, because it's your General Scry ring that you're going to have here. So General Scry, it's Fist of War, it's Earth Shatter, it's Brutality, and it's Concentrated Effects, and it's Melee Physical Damage. Why Concentrated Effects? Because this is in the build for single target. It's very strange that I'm saying that. But most of the time you will not need it on packs. But once that you're on a boss and you do desecrated ground. So that means corpse on the ground. You can start using this. And they are just going to attack the boss. You do the General's Cry again. It's going to explode and over again. This is a main single target DPS in the build. You will see if you go to Path of Building, it's around 2 million DPS you will do with this setup. So that's what you need to have for the weapon. Then we are going to the helmet because it's very easy gear. It's not a very complicated build. The enchantment here, ignore that, because what is good, mana reservation on pride, try to take it, it's going to be very cheap, it's not that expensive on a normal helmet. What do you need? Life, of course, resistance, that's more than enough. If you can get a little bit richer, you can take that enemies take more physical damage, but it's all just standard, resistance, life, it will always come back, armor, and that's it. Then the next step is the amulet. Always go for a turquoise. Why a turquoise? Because you need to have some dexterity, intelligence. Once again, just the same. Add physical damage, life, and resistance. You can, of course, craft on this amulet if you don't have enough AOE. Just increase the AOE from the bench here. But go for the turquoise. I got here the tick skin, that's just an increased life that I got here. Chance to avoid elemental ailments. My goal is at the end and in the new league too to be 100% ailment avoidance. That means that you cannot get ignite anymore, frozen, shocked, I think, and there is one more, and I totally forgot about that one. That's the goal, but I don't want to put that yet in the build, because it needs to be very simple that you can start the build, and that you don't see gear that thinks, oh, I need to have the veiled mobs, and all that stuff. So, therefore, I keep it simple at the moment. So, turquoise, then the next step, the rings. What do you need to have on the rings? Add physical damage here, you are going to cap your resistance, life again. Try to put a catalyst on them to buff them. So get the ring with very high resistance, the basic ones, fire, cold, and lightning. Try to go to 20%. I still need to do 5% more here. If you can get a vermilion ring, try to get it. It's nice life. Is it needed at the start? No, because you got so much life at the moment that you almost take no damage in maps. So you still have a play field that you can work your way up. Then the other ring, just the same a little bit, but here you need to have vulnerability. Vulnerability is very important. This is going to be expensive. You will pay 1-2 exalted for this ring. But that's one of the two expensive things in the build. So vulnerability, you will see that if you get this ring and you will put vulnerability on the enemies, you will get like a very big DPS boost really quick. You will see right away the difference. It's expensive, but it's very good to have it in the build. You guys see that I got channeling skills have -3 to total mana cost. It's going to reduce to 5. I can go to 2, so that you only use 2 for the cyclone. At the start you will not get this, so therefore be sure that you got reservation, mana reservation of pride. I think it's now called difference efficiency or something, but be sure you will get that before you probably get the minus to channeling skills cost. But at the end you will always have enough mana. Then another thing. The gloves. So the gloves, once again, get spike gloves. I got here my mana leech on it. They are very good. Start with life, just resistance. You can work your way up on that moment. Accuracy, just ignore it here. I took this for the increased attack speed. Very good for cyclone builds. Then the build. So go for a Stitch and Vice live again. Chaos Resistance is very good here too. Try to get above zero for Chaos Resistance. The jewel that I'm using, get Onslaught on it, so that you got Onslaught on it. Then for the boots, increased movement speed, try to get 30, life again, and resistance. So it's always the same that comes back. And I'm going to show you guys the setups too on the gems, because I totally forgot it. So here I got Enlightened 4, I got Blood and Sand, I got Flesh and Stone, and I got Pride. Enlightened 4, it's hard to get, I know it. Do you need it? No, you don't need it. You can have an Enlightened 3 if you got the Pride Mana Reservation enchant on your helmet. It will work too. Then for the Cyclone setup, Cyclone, Shockwave. Shockwave, very important, guys. Therefore, I'm going with the Maul, or you can go with the Staff. But Shockwave is the killer on, just doing trash. It just let explode the trash, because a lot of people always ask me, yeah, but Cyclone, you do almost no DPS. No, but the Shockwave is doing a lot of more DPS than you think. It's not in a Path of Building either, but that's how you can one-shot the groups in packs, even tier 60 maps. You guys just saw it in my, what was it, gameplay that you just saw. But Shockwave, take it. It's going to make your life a lot easier on, clearing maps. Pulverize to get more AoE. The more AoE on Cyclone, the better. Here I'm using Awakening Melee Physical Damage. Just go Melee Physical Damage. If you're getting a little bit further in the game, you can get the Awakening one. Then here I got Impale, of course, and Brutality, because it's a physical damage build. On the gloves, we got here Dreadbanner. Otherwise, I'm not capped on the percentage hit now. I'm above 100% chance to get Impale. Therefore, I put it here. Here I got Molten Shell. Molten Shell is on bottom, the running bottom, that you always use it. If you are on a boss, you need to do it like this. You can just proc it if you need it, but put it on button number 1, that you can use it the whole time. It's always extra HP that you get, that's always very, very good. Then here we got Ascentral Warchief with multiple totems. Very good DPS boost. Pop it on the boss and you destroy bosses. With the Earth Shatter, with the spikes that explode, and with the Cyclone. You guys saw it on Chimera. And then here for the last setup, that's something very special. So I got here Cast When Damage Taken 1. Why one? Because here is my Desecrate and my Blood Rage. So it needs to proc really quick. So the moment that I take very low damage, I got desecrated on the ground. What is desecrated doing? It put corpses on the ground. So you got corpses on the ground, and then you can use your General's Cry. Don't take it higher than 1. It needs to proc as soon as possible, otherwise you cannot use General's Cry. Leap Slam is here too. It does not need to be in the link, of course, because Leap Slam is just mobility, but this is very important. So you will always proc Cast When Damage Taken, Blood Rage, and you will get desecrated on the ground. Very essential, otherwise it's not working. So that's it, a little bit very simple, but it works really, really well. I played this build previous league. Now with the updates, it's so good. It's unbelievable how good it plays. Another thing, so for the flask. So I got on my life flask, increased recovery rate. Here I got immunity for bleed. I'm immune for corrupted bleed with the jewel in the tree. I will show you guys it really quick. And then you need to work on all the ailments that you can have. So that's frozen, that's shocked, that's ignite. That's bleed. And poison I got in the Phantoms. So what do I got here? So if I become shocked, I got immunity for shock for 4 seconds. So shock is gone. It's going to be automatically. You don't need to do a lot. Work as soon as possible on these guys. If you go to mapping, be sure that you got it, because ailments kill you. You can come to a boss, bang, you're dead, you think by yourself what happened, so work on it. You can get every utility flask, because I'm now working on an armor one. So just get the utility flask that you like, that you won't have. Just put this on it. You will find orbs like this. Instilling orb, so it will enchant the utility flask. and when a certain condition is met, it's going to be used. I got this too, so when I get shocked, I'm going to use this flask, and it's going to give me immunity to shock. Therefore, it's good. The next one is for frozen. If I become frozen, I get immunity to freeze and chill. So it's going to get rid of frozen. The next one is just the Quicksilver one, to speed it up a little bit, but here I'm immunity to bleeding too. It's not really needed. I need to take here immunity to ignite, because for ignite, I'm not... I don't have immunity. So it was better that I put immunity of ignite on this one and this one. So try to do it. Why I don't take ignite, because ignite is not really that hard to overcome for my build. But if you want to be very secure the whole time, take immunity on ignite too. Then we got Lion's Roar. It's still the one that the setup or the stats before the nerf. I think it's now 7 to 10 more physical damage, but I don't have another one. That's the problem. So I will put the right one in Path of Building. I'm not going to cheat on the DPS, because I know this is the old one, but that's the Lion's Roar. Really quick on the tree, because in Path of Building, it's calculated the masteries, but you cannot see them. Therefore, I'm going to say it really quick to you guys. The masteries, they are in heaven. It's unbelievable how good they are. You can do so much more things. I do it really quick because I got a lot of masteries. What are masteries? It's something that you can take inside the cluster. I think that you need to take two or three small passives around it, and then you can take it. But it opens so many things because you don't need to travel anymore. So on the mace, what do I got here? Crush enemies on hit with maces and scepters. Then here, very important, I got 3 Warcry masteries. Remove an ailment when you Warcry. I'm every 1.8 second I'm doing General's Cry, so I can do it the whole time. Recover 15% of life when you use Warcry, and 20% increased damage for each time you Warcried recently. Of course, you need to put the masteries on 3 Warcry nodes. You cannot take it on one, so I got it here, here, and here. That's how I come on 3 masteries for the Warcries. Then we are coming here to the two-handed masteries. 3% chance to deal triple damage, 40% increased damage with hits against rare and unique enemies. It's this one and this one. Then the life ones is a 10% increased maximum life and plus 50 on maximum life. It's this one and it's this one. Then we are going to the fortify ones. Of course, you need to have fortify, another very good buff. You don't need to get overlord anymore. You just hit enemies, melee hits fortify. I got minus to fortify. How does it work? You got now points. I got 26, that means 26 less damage taken. That's a lot. So you see it here. I got another one here too. Plus 3 to maximum fortification. That's how I come to 26. And then I got all the masteries, I think. I just wanted to show you guys it. Because it's not in Path of Building. Now I'm going to show you guys Path of Building and the stats. The next part, guys, Path of Building. And I'm going to keep it short. The link to this is under the video too. A couple of things I'm going to say to you guys. So first of all, the DPS. The last video that I made about this build, so it was just... not a complete build. It was just before the launch of 3.16. People always say to me, yeah, the DPS is very low on the Cyclone. Yeah, that's true, but Cyclone is not really the main DPS in this build. So it's very beautiful, this build. Why? Because you got Shockwave on Cyclone, so you got more than enough DPS to clear packs. But then General's Cry is for the bossing, is for if you come on a map across rare enemies. And that's the main source of the DPS. So if you see here, Cyclone is 500,000 DPS. But if you go to General's Cry, you see it here. So you go to have a look to the initial impact. It's 1.3 million DPS for my 5 warriors. And if you let the spikes explode, it's another million almost DPS. So at the end, this build got almost 3 million DPS for a very tanky juggernaut. because it's very defensive heavy, this build, but that's the DPS. So you're looking to 3 million DPS in this build, so don't look only to the Cyclone, because it's not a wrong number, but it's not the total picture that you will see here. Another thing, bandits take 2 passive points. The Phantoms, I will discuss them with you guys right away after path of building. So my configuration, everything is here. I did not put a lot of things up, just the frenzies, the endurance charges, onslaught and 26 fortification, because fortify is going to buff my DPS too in this tree. So how does it work? What is important? First of all, the ascendancy is important, so what do you need to take? Very straight on, you take unstoppable, then you take this one, unflinching, because if your level endurance charges are very handy, then you can choose the pants. This is going to give you more DPS, is going to boost your AoE on your Cyclone, and this is going to make you almost invisible. Another 5% reduced damage taken. That's 31 reduced damage taken that I got in the build. 26, 45, and then this again. That makes it very strong. So that's the ascendancy. For leveling, very straight on. Just take this. I would leave the Warcry notes, because I got a lot of them. Because why did I take a lot of Warcry notes? Because I want to get my cooldown on General Cry as small as possible. It's 1.8 seconds only, so that means that you can spam it almost the whole time. And therefore, this cluster, I would wait to take them when you are hitting like the end game mapping, because you really don't need it. You already saw what it can do. The ailments are gone. I get 15% HP every time that I hit General's Cry. Therefore, it's very good. And I took them all. Another thing that is very important, this one. So be sure that it's instant, because otherwise you're going to interrupt your Cyclone. That's very important too. And then it's straight on. You start here, take those notes, then you come over here. And then you go to this area. Here is Resolute Techniques, because it's a Resolute Technique build. I cannot make an critical build from it. Be sure that you take the impales too. This cluster is needed with the dread banner, and then you're capped on the hit chance. That's very important too. And yeah, you cannot do a lot wrong with this build. So keep the clusters at the end. Go to Resolute Techniques, then you work here a little bit. Very simple. There is not really one thing that is complicated. For the jewels, I already told it. Corrupted Blood is here on this jewel. And I got this one too. This is the second very expensive thing that you're going to have. I tested it without it, and I don't really see a difference. Because it's in the Cyclone. Therefore, the Cyclone is not the main source of DPS, but it's a good investment, but it's 15 Exalted. If you don't have it, get life, add physical damage, maybe some Dexterity Intelligence, if you are not capped yet. But is it needed? No, it's not needed. You can go without it with the build. And that's it, guys. I cannot say more. Under the video, you will see it. And that was a path of building. The last part of the video, so the Phantoms, they buffed them really well, the Phantoms. So in the past they were already worth to take them, but now they are even better. So what do I always take? Because there is one ailment, I'm not really sure that poison is an ailment, by the way, but there is still one ailment that is going to fuck me over sometime, and that is poison. So therefore I take Soul of Shakiri. So 50% less duration of poison on you. You cannot be poisoned while there are at least 3 poisons on you. So that's very good. What is very hard for the build sometimes too is Chaos damage over time. So therefore I took 5% reduced Chaos damage. I'm not on Caustic Ground at the moment, so the other thing is not doing anything. And therefore I took the Soul of Arakali too, because 40% Chaos resistance against damage over time. You can take other things too, because I saw this one too. So now the Soul of the Brine King is straight on, cannot be frozen. So that's very good too. But the main problem is that the other things, I don't need them, because I got the ascendancy that I cannot get stunned. So you cannot be stunned. And I always think it's a little bit silly that you take ascendancy that overlap other things that you already can mitigate. Another thing, let me have a look, there was another one too, because I think that you can have only 3 stacks on corrupted blood is here somewhere too. Here it is. That they changed to corrupted blood cannot be inflicted on you if you have at least 5 corrupted blood debuffs on you too. So it's not going to take that hard, but you guys need to check a little bit what you need at the moment, because I can show you guys this, what I need, but if you are in the game and, for example, you cannot roll on your utility flask or you don't have the orbs, cannot be frozen, then it's probably best that you take first this one before you take this one. So you need to see a little bit how you progress to the game, because at the start you don't start with all the settings that you need to have. And even if you're mapping and you're a little bit unlucky, there is always some RNG involved in this game. You can be very unlucky and you don't have the resources to get the ailment immunity for a certain school. Then you need to adapt a little bit. So I can just say to you, you got frozen here, you got corrupted blood here, you got poison immunity. It's not immunity, but it's not going to stack that you die. That's very essential. So play a little bit around with it, but I take this one and this one. So thanks for watching this video. To end the video, I will show you guys very quick how you need to play the build. Yeah, it's very simple. You just turn around the whole time and you just push 2. That's all what you need to do. And if you got like spike damage, be sure that you proc your Vaal Molten Shell. If you're on a boss, you do 3 and 4 to get the totems out. 4 in total. You can use the Ascentral Warsheath and the normal one at the same moment. And that's all what you need to do. For the other part, you don't need to do a lot. Sometimes get your Lion's Roar out. Very simple build. I'm not the best player, therefore I always need to make very tanky builds, because otherwise I always die. That was it. Have fun in 3.16. I already start to level this build on the Scorch League. I'm not sure how it's going to work on the Scorch mechanic. But the first signs are very positive. I think it's going to work really well. Because the DPS is decent, but most of all the defensive are decent. Because I got the impression that the mechanic, the Scorch mechanic, is very relying on defensive instead of DPS. So thanks for watching, have fun, bye bye.